considered buying one of those magic pills that promise to make the fat melt away? Well, I have definitely been tempted on more than one occasion, and we have all been in a situation where we have wanted to lose a few kgs, whether it's for that vacation, for a wedding, for a party, or so many other reasons. So let me tell you that growing up, while in college and all through my childhood and adolescence, I have been a very chubby baby. So I know how hard it is to lose weight. The one thing that you need to do in order to start losing weight is make a change. Change. C-H-A-N-G-E is all you need to do in order to start seeing results and start losing weight. They say that if you want to see different results, you need to start doing things differently. So if you want to see a change in your body and in the shape of your body, you need to change something that you are doing to your body.
Let me start by telling you that there are three main pieces to the weight loss puzzle. One is what you feed your mind. Two is what you feed your body. And three is the exercise and the physical activity that you put your body through. These are the three main things that will help you lose weight. And you need to bring change in each one of these three aspects that you are feeding yourself with. So let's start with what you're feeding your mind with, what your thoughts are. And this is where I see most people going wrong, including me. We tend to think that our thoughts are insignificant. Just because no one else can hear our thoughts, we think that they do not matter. But thoughts are very important. Thoughts are energy that we release into the universe and into our body. The universe and our bodies, they listen. They listen to every thought of ours and they follow our every instruction. So what thoughts are running through your mind right now? Oh God, I've put on so much weight. No matter what I do, I just don't seem to be losing that weight. My God, she eats just about everything under the sun and she's so skinny. And look at me. Even if I just hear the word food, I tend to put on weight. I cannot tell you how many times I have heard people say these things to themselves out loud and in their mind over and over again. And I have been guilty of doing this as well. When you say something to yourself over and over again, it becomes a belief. It becomes something that the body starts to follow to a T. Even if you starve, you will not lose weight. Exercise will not make you thin. When you say these things to yourself over and over and over again, the body starts to respond in the same manner. So stop this now. Make a change in what you are feeding your mind. Please make a change today. Start giving yourself thin thoughts, slim thoughts, healthy thoughts. No matter what I eat, I feel fit and beautiful. I love healthy food that nourishes my body. The moment I start exercising, fat just seems to be melting away. Your thoughts are very, very powerful. Use them to your advantage. That's the first change I need you to make. So let's come now to the second piece of the puzzle, which is what you feed your body. Your food. No matter how healthy or how unhealthy you are eating right now, all you need to do is make one big change or a few little changes in order to start seeing weight loss results. So what change can you make? What I can tell you to do is that note down everything that you put into your mouth. Every little thing that you put into your mouth needs to be written down. Now, I know you've heard this before and I know it sounds very, very boring and I know that it sounds like too much of an effort. But I'm not telling you to do it forever. Just do it for 2 days. Do it for 2 days and you will be able to understand things that you have taken for granted and things that have gone unnoticed. For example, for me, I realized that although I was eating a very healthy breakfast, lunch and dinner, I was eating a lot of junk in between these meals. So each time I would go across the kitchen, I would eat a few chips, or I would eat a little biscuit every now and then when my kids were eating them, or I would indulge in the occasional Maggie. So I realized that those little things that I was thinking, oh, just one piece of chocolate, just a few chips, add up by the end of the day and they all accumulate on my hips and on the tummy. For example, understand how much refined sugar you are having and substitute some of that refined sugar with natural sugar, maybe a fruit. If you are having too much white food, too much bread, too much pasta, cut that down. Add a portion of vegetables to every meal that you eat. If you're eating outside too much, try and bring that down, restrict it to only the weekends. If you're having meals that are very, very infrequent, try and make more frequent meals. Just make some change. Without changing what you're putting inside your body, you will not see a change outside.
So that brings us to the third piece of the puzzle, which is your exercise. So what changes can you make? If you have never worked out in your life, and if the only workout you get is changing channels on your remote, just start walking, okay? Walk for an hour every day. If you've been walking and you've been walking for a long time and you're not seeing changes, start jogging. If you have been jogging, start running. If you can't jog or run, walk for 2 minutes, run for 2 minutes, walk for 2 minutes, run for 2 minutes. Push yourself a little harder. Bring up the intensity of your workout. If you have been running, start weight training. Weights are excellent. They help you build muscle and muscle helps you burn fat. A high intensity interval training. If you do not have the time, this is an excellent way to get an intense workout in a short period of time. There are so many kinds of different workouts that you could try. Another change that you can make in your workout is the duration that you work out for. Did you know that the first few minutes, around 20 to 30 minutes of your workout, your body is only burning carbohydrates? It is after the first 15, 20, 30, depending upon your level of fitness, it is after that threshold level that your body starts burning fat. So imagine if you stop after the first 15 or 20 minutes, you are just burning the carbohydrates and not getting to the fat that is sitting safe and pretty on the hips. So maybe you could change the duration of your workouts. These are the three important pieces of the weight loss puzzle. Number one, what you're feeding your mind. Number two, what you're feeding your body. And number three, how you are exercising. Please sit down today and think about your thoughts. Be a little more conscious of your thoughts and see what you're telling yourself about your body and about your weight. Number two, think and note down what you are eating and where you can make a change. Number three, how are you working out and what change can you make in your workout in order to start seeing the results that you dream of? So make changes in these three aspects of your body. And let me know what changes you are making. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and please subscribe for more such videos. Remember, you will not see a difference in your body and in your life if you keep doing the same things over and over again. In order to see a change, in order to see a difference in your body and in your life, you need to change the things that you are doing.